Hi everyone. So today we're taking a look at the Raspberry Pi Mark II, otherwise known as simply the Raspberry Pi 2. Now, obviously, Raspberry have done a phenomenal job over the last few years, really building out the offering for the Raspberry Pi and what you can do with it. But it was starting to feel a little long in the tooth. That single core processor, 512 of RAM, it really wasn't suitable for modern projects, especially if those projects happen to involve a number of different stacks running on that single Pi. So, with the Raspberry Pi 2, they've looked to make a correction, and a correction that will set them in very, very good stead for the next 3 years at least. The Raspberry Pi 2 moves us to a quad-core processor backed up with 1 gig of RAM. Now, when you actually look at the board, things haven't changed that much. This is still the B+ form factor, 4 USB ports and so on, but the memory has been split out of the CPU, now residing on the back of the board as a separate chip. But the profile and the size and the physical dimensions and the locations of all the ports are identical. Essentially, this is the B+ board, just a damn sight faster. So how much faster? Well, Raspberry Pi is saying it's 6 times faster based on benchmarks. That's fine, it gives us a line in the sand, but ultimately benchmarks are synthetic and they're not really going to tell us how this device really performs in the real world. So, having put the Raspberry Pi 2 through its paces for around the last week, we can tell you very clearly that this is the fastest Raspberry Pi ever released. That was kind of to be expected, but when we're talking about booting into the X interface in under 20 seconds, it's quite a remarkable achievement. Browsing around the interface, using applications, browsing the web, playing back media, everything works incredibly snappy here. You almost feel like you're using a full-sized computer. It's quite remarkable how much of a difference that quad-core and 1 gig of RAM really does make to the Raspberry Pi ecosystem. I can certainly see a lot of projects now being much more easy to put together and keep running successfully now we have a lot more RAM available. But also that quad-core processor really does open up the parallel processing opportunities. No longer are we seeing the Raspberry Pi getting bogged down doing, well, what it needs to do. Now it seems to be a case that there's always plenty of extra performance available exactly when you need it. It's going to be very interesting to see how this kind of develops over this next year, especially with Microsoft saying they're going to be bringing the Windows 10 command line interface, the PowerShell, directly to the Raspberry Pi. It does mean we won't be seeing a fully fledged Windows, as it were, but certainly the fact that Microsoft and Ubuntu are now both able to get their distributions up and running on the Raspberry Pi is going to open things up massively for makers everywhere. The price remains unchanged, which is another major plus point in the Raspberry Pi's favour. Picking these up for around £30, including VAT, is an absolute bargain. It really is. And the future of ultra-portable maker computer systems has never been rosier. Thanks for watching. Don't forget, you can pledge $1 a month on Patreon to help support the Androidizen, keeping us 100% independent. An honest opinion direct from the UK. If you pledge $1 a month, you'll be entered into our prize pool to win cool items from our review bag. Also, don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment. We love to chat.